Hi there, beautiful people. Good morning from Dhaka, Bangladesh. Today I'm reviewing a fragrance that has been discontinued some few years back, and this fragrance house basically is under new ownership, and they are sort of like redoing a lot of their fragrances and kind of like laying off, like, or I don't know, discontinue some of their perfumes from House of Valentino. This is called Valentino Noir Absolu Oud Essence. Okay, this is a beautiful black dark fragrance, and we'll talk about this one because this one doesn't have that many reviews on it. And there are quite a few reviews. I watched some of them. They are really good. I think the most important to me always is Rob08, his review, and he reviewed this. You know, I really liked his initial take. I wish he did like full-on review on that one if he hasn't done it already. So I'm very excited to talk about, give you my initial impression. I did one wearing today. I received the bottle today, so basically I'll give you initial impression, what to expect, season, who can wear it, longevity, a smell, how it develops, who is it for, that sort of thing. Okay, so I think they have four in this line. One is Valentino Noir, Valentino Uomo Noir, Valentino Uomo, what is that called? Valentino Uomo, Valentino Uomo one is this one, the Oud Essence. There's a Musk Essence, there's like Noir Absolu. I think that one is Valentino Uomo Noir Absolu. Yeah, that is the dark one with the black and gold, and they have a Femme. I think there are four. So I think all of these at this point are discontinued. If you find these at good prices, like $150 below, take a look at these if you like this kind of scent profile. This is very different kind of stuff, very borderline niche kind of stuff. If you like a little bit daring, Armani Privé line or something in the line of Gucci, or you know, Tom Ford ish you know, if you like those lines, keep watching. Okay, so this is a unisex release, 2018 release, I believe. 100 ml EDP concentration, the name is there, box gold and black, really nice presentation. And then somewhere inside it looks like that, box bottle stays inside. I took it out already, batch code and all that. So this one, the bottle looks a little bit different. You have seen my review. If you haven't, check out my review. I'll leave the link below of let's take this off, man, the hair is like, you know, after shower hair is all messy. So yeah, so basically I was saying Valentino Uomo, Valentino Uomo Aqua Intense, Noir Absolu, I did cover those four, and Born in Roma, few more I did. I'll leave the link below, check out my individual reviews. This is the bottle that does not look like those. Okay, this bottle is just so badass, you know. It's like dark, you know, it reminds me of Estée Dupont, one of the bottles. It has a studded pattern, got this golden, you know, plate in front, got this cap like stopper, it'll stop it from spraying in the luggage, I suppose. Base, you get some more information. The thing is, that's about it, I guess. Nice to hold, not that chunky. I didn't want to bring out, a little bit tired today, so I didn't want to bring out my other Valentino Uomo bottles. I perhaps will get Oud Absolu, sorry, Valentino Uomo, man, what's the name? Noir Absolu. Yeah, if I can get that at a good price, I'll buy it again. Okay, so this fragrance I did try this afternoon. It was a bit sunny, probably not the right weather to wear it, but I kind of enjoyed it, you know, staying at home, a little bit cool, and I got some idea. Okay, let's spray this and talk about it. I guess the cap is, can be a little bit painful, it gets stuck down there, I don't know why, man. These I hate. I always told you these look very cheap on Salvatore, these bottles. They could have put just like a stopper right on the neck, that would do the purpose. Anyway, to each his own. Okay, I really like this bottle design. Apart from that, it looks really nice. Okay, let's spray this. So in this hand I have something, this hand is empty. Okay, let's just go here. Okay, sprayer is okay, sprayer is good, like smooth sprayer, check out. Okay, gives out distribution about this much and decent distribution. I am happy with this. Okay, how many sprays to go with this? This perfume, I think ideal application would be 4 to 5 sprays. This is good for colder months. Okay, this is dark, this is a dark beauty. I'll give you some examples of similar fragrances, but mild cold weather to cold weathers, this is appropriate. Nighttime, you can see from theme, crowd, mature. This fragrance I will never ever recommend to people who are in school, college, or you know, like younger crowd. They may find this stuff to be a little bit serious, too serious for their liking and their, you know, crowd or wherever they hang out. This fragrance perhaps will be not a good idea. Okay, as far as it being unisex vibe, yeah, I can see it, but I think anyway, so I was telling you, like, this could be a good unisex perfume, but men would like this so much more. I can see it. It's when I smell this, you know, let's go into the smell. Okay, let's go about the longevity. When I wore for first time, I wore like 3 sprays, okay, here, both side of my shoulder. And I got about 1.5 hour of projection. I could detect it after that, all together from my skin and shirt combined, I got about 4.5 hours. So if some may say this is below par or average, it's not a beast. It's not like Valentino Intense or Diorome Intense. It doesn't quite have that push. But I think it's just the skin chemistry. It's about wearing and getting used to it. Perhaps I'll give it a lot more wearing in the coming winter days. The performance for the initial impression, it's like better than average. It's like above average. It's not mind-blowing, but that's about that, you know. So price range, this is going to cost you money now. $100 is going to cost you money. You can get this in Bangladesh if you contact our page USB. They will bring it for you. They have good pricing on this. So when things get discontinued, you know, any price is fair. You know, people ask for $150, you can't say anything. These are a bit rare to find nowadays. So when I smell this, you know, first thing Mark says is Barnier-y, kind of like that skanky Middle Eastern niche line, you know, niche borderlining fragrance. I can definitely see what he said. It smells like something Baikilian would make, okay? Something Tom Ford would make, something a Middle Eastern company like Amouage would make, okay? If I can draw your attention now, you know. This is very smoky, very dark, very gothic, very much like, you know, not Barnier-y, I would say, but something serious oud makers would make. The opening is just very smoky, not resinous. It's very smoky, dark, less sweetness. Is there any rose? No. This reminds me of Black to Black by Mancera. Some of the Mancera's oud, okay? So if you like woody, like really dark woody, and if you like smoke, and then you like leather, this is the combination of those things. You know, three basic things is in there. There may be other things like few other notes. I don't remember. I don't have Fragrantica open. But there are some other notes like mortal. I don't know. There's a note and a few other notes. But what it offered me, oh, there is saffron, definite saffron. So saffron, oud, leather, woody notes, and smoke. That's what you get from this. It's a very daring fragrance. Trust me, when I say like dark, think of Interlude or also fragrance like Estée Dupont, Oudet Santal. This is similar to Black Afghano. Same vein, same family. So definitely it's a blind buy, and would I call it success for my liking? It's a success. It's a fragrance I would like. It's like in my upcoming, you know, like when I say my interest, the way it developed my taste, where I'm in the journey, this is a beautiful fragrance. If you like pencil shavings, like Gucci Purum 1, if you like something a little bit spicy, you'll thoroughly enjoy this. If you especially live in Canada or somewhere in the colder countries, live by the mountains, you'll appreciate this. If you have a mature nose, you'll appreciate this. So in the end, initial impression, I like it a lot. I like plenty, but I cannot recommend people to buy this blind, okay? It's a beautiful perfume, no doubt, but it's not for everybody, okay? Fair and square. It's a little bit animalic. It's really like when you wear it for 15 minutes, that opening skanky vibe, a little bit like a butt smell or a little bit like foot. It smells like Bigfoot, you know? There's this myth, that mythical creature. If Bigfoot had a smell, it could be like this, but it's not a skank, you know? So I would not say this is like gonna make you stink or people despise you, nothing like it. But it takes a little bit like gutsy men, like leather jacket, John Varvatos, or Philip Plain, they'll make. So you get the idea, okay? So longevity and projection, I have to wear it more, but it feels like average and above, okay, a little bit. Overall scent profile is really nice. Uniqueness wise, it is basically, if you talk about westernized perfumes, kudos to them. This is those top tier designer fragrance quality when it comes to oud. This basically could be Valentino's niche line, okay? They could sell this for $150, it would sell still, okay? So that's quality stuff in there. If you like Gucci Guilty Absolute, if you like Black Afghano, Tom Ford Noir, EDP, some of the spicy woody ones, or that one, Oudet Santal or Black Afghano, try this out. This fragrance is definitely mysterious. It's serious. Wear it with leather jacket or gloves, biking. I think this is gonna do some really nice theme with your bike ride, okay? Especially if you like a leather jacket dude, if you like rough and tough, if you smoke cigars, you know, this fragrance will work for you. Really nice perfume. Some people see in the end note, one note is that it's good for layering. I don't know what that means, you know. Fragrance are good on its own, bro. I mean, you can wear it on its own. It's fine, you know. The fragrance, if you have to blend five fragrances, what's the point of buying five fragrances? Buy one fragrance that has everything, you know. So I feel like this one is not like a layering fragrance sort of fragrance. It has its own character. It's interesting enough, but it's for very close sort of crowd. It's not going to be for everybody. If you like Valentino more intense, high likely you may not like it as much as that. Okay. So now, so thing is like, the bottle is lovely. 10 out of 10 for the bottle. Presentation is beautiful. It's rare item, makes me more happy. And I will wear it more because it smells interesting. It doesn't smell boring. It's always like moving to the next territory. It's definitely worthy for that. But try a sample before buying. That's it. Opening initial impression for this, I will give it like a solid 9 out of 10 for the smell itself. Presentation, everything, you know, 9 out of 10. But performance, you have to see. Thanks for watching, guys. And you can check with USB if they still have stock on that. Try to get it if you are interested. Very soon they will be called for the market. Have a nice day. Good night from Dhaka, Bangladesh. Thanks for watching. Thanks for always your support. Take care. Bye-bye.